How to use Phase Shift like a pro. Hey guys, welcome to another guide. Today I'll be talking about how to use the phase shift. And the concept of the phase shift is really similar to the last stand, but you're limited to firing your own weapons. And ability is 5 seconds and then you have 40 seconds cooldown. So you do have the flexibility to use it again, but you are using the power cells. Okay, so first tip I'm gonna give you here is use it to take a beacon. Now, some beacons don't have covers. For example, this beacon in the center. Now, with the phase shift, I was able to help out getting the center beacon here. And on to the next clip, be creative. Use robot's ability together with the phase shift and come up with your own creative way to figure out how to capture a beacon. And here's another footage of me at the end of the game being able to pressure and go for this beacon right here using the phase shift. On to number two, use it to move cover to cover. Okay, now some bots, their weakness is mobility. They're too slow. So using phase shift, you can move to a cover and avoid getting attacked. Even with its great mobility, a lot of jumpers get shot at during its airtime, so during its airtime, use the phase shift to avoid getting shot. So on number three, if you don't have the last stand, then use it like a last stand on your brawler. So the concept of last stand and the phase shifts are really similar. There's a little bit of different story behind it, being in parallel world and stuff, but the idea is similar. So use it, if you don't have it, use it like your last stand. Obviously it is a little bit different, you can't fire back, but you do have the flexibility to use it again. Once you wait 40 seconds, you'll have your phase shift back. On number four, use it to avoid being a target. So during a busy brawl, it can get pretty hectic and you can be attacked from all different angles, and definitely you can avoid being a target by using the phase shift, lasting longer during that brawl. And this is another great example of really avoiding getting unnecessary damage. On to number five, use it to save your last stand. So if you have the last stand and if you're using the phase shift, you can really efficiently use it to last longer in engagements. So efficiently using the phase shift right before your last stand, you're able to either stay alive for a lot longer or use that last stand onto the next engagement. On number six, use it to get close. In this clip, I was able to avoid a lot of firepower directed at me, and I was able to deliver that explosion right to multiple enemies. And of course, a lot of robots have shields, and especially against Pantheon bots where you can't take down their shield, it's really convenient to use the phase shift to get inside of their shield and attack. On number seven, use it to counter the last stand. So previously I did say the phase shift and the last stand are very similar concept. However, With the phase shift, you're able to activate this ability whenever you want. So by using the phase shift ability right after my enemy's last stand has been triggered, I was able to win this engagement. So last but not least, on number 8, use it with pilot skills. And there are pilot skills that enhance active modules. And these are the 4 main ones that you see here. Number 1 really makes your module effect last longer by 25% max. On number 2, Dodger, your cooldown on your active module is shortened. Number 3, Foolhardy Quartermaster. Once your robot's HP goes down to 50%, you're able to use that active module again. In this case, phase shift. And on number 4, Quartermaster, this actually reduces the power cell amount per use. So definitely think about using these 4 pilot skills if your playstyle depend on this active module. So thank you guys for watching my guide, and like and subscribe and comment about what topic I should cover next. And I also have a channel of my own, so be sure to check out my channel as well. See you guys.